I have had fever for the last few days. I checked my fever on a clinical thermometer and the reading was 100 degrees Celsius, which is approximately 2 degrees higher than the normal reading. Do you remember the normal human body temperature? The normal human body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius or 98.4 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm sure all of you now know about the use of the thermometer. But can we measure the temperature of hot water with a clinical thermometer? I want to know that. Why do hot things become cold and cold things become warm? Let us look for answers to a few such questions through this story. The objectives of this video are 1. To understand about laboratory thermometer. 2. To understand how heat flows. 3. To understand what are conductors and insulators.
Ravi, drink the milk or it will become cold.
Mother, this milk is still so hot. Can you please make it cold for me? Mother, can we measure the temperature of this milk with a clinical thermometer?
No, Ravi, it can be dangerous. Clinical thermometer is used only to measure body temperature. To measure the temperature of water, milk or the weather, we use the laboratory thermometer.
You kept this hot glass of milk in a bowl of cold water. And look, it has become cold in some time. But look, now this water has become warm. Does it mean that heat flows from hot object to cold object?
Yes, you are right, Ravi. Heat flows from hot object to cold object.
Oh, is that the reason my ice cream melted yesterday?
Yes, children, heat flows from a hot material to a cold material.
Ravi, I brought your science book back. I have a lot of doubts. I will have to ask the teacher a lot of questions tomorrow.
Why? What happened? Why did you not understand?
I have doubts in the chapter on heat.
Ravi, can you please stir the vegetable on the gas with the spoon?
Oh, this spoon is so hot.
There is a wooden spoon. Use that.
Oh, this wooden spoon did not get hot. But that steel spoon had become so hot.
Yes. There is mention on the same in our science book too. But what could be the reason for this?
Ramesh, let us do an experiment. Let us take different objects made up of different materials. Then let us dip them in hot water one by one. Let us then observe what happens to each object.
Children, I shall warm the water and give it to you.
Look, Ramesh, I have this wooden spoon, steel spoon, this pair of scissors, this plastic scale, and this ceramic spoon. Come, let us dip all of them in this hot water.
Look, Ravi, this steel spoon has become so hot, and this wooden spoon, plastic spoon, and ceramic spoon haven't become hot.
This pair of scissors made of iron has become so hot. Yes, Ramesh, I have also noticed that when we play on the slides in the park, the slide made of iron becomes so hot.
So, it means that some materials like wood, plastic, etc. do not let heat pass through it?
And materials like steel, iron allow heat to pass through them.
Good observation, children. The materials which let heat pass through them are good conductors of heat and are known as conductors. The objects which do not allow transfer of heat are poor conductors of heat and are known as insulators.
Oh, that is the reason a few utensils have plastic handles. Because if the utensil contains something hot, the heat does not transfer to the handle and we do not burn our fingers.
Yes, you are right. The sun also gives so much of heat, and because of that, the air and water in rivers and sea becomes hot. So are air and water conductors or insulators?
Friends, we learned that heat is transferred from a hot to a cold object. The materials which let heat pass through them are known as conductors, and the materials which do not allow heat to pass through them are known as insulators. Ravi asked a question. What could be the answer to that? Are air and water conductors or insulators? We shall look for the answer to this in the next video. We shall meet soon. Heat, Part 3. The objectives of this video are 1. To understand about convection. 2. To understand about natural convection in coastal regions. 3. To understand why do we wear clothes according to the weather. Hello friends, how are all of you? I had been to Goa for a few days. Goa is a beautiful beach destination in Maharashtra. How is it that a beach always has a pleasant atmosphere? Have you ever thought that why do we wear light colors in summers and dark colors in winter? Come, let us find the answers to such questions with the characters of the story Mala and Raja.
Mother, I want hot water to take a bath. Can you boil some water for me?
Yes, Raja. Wait for a while till the water heats up.
Mother, the water close to the flame heats up faster, right?
Yes, Raja.
Then all of the water heats up together.
Like you said, that the water near the flame heats up first. Then it rises up. Then the cold water around it takes its place. Then similarly, the water heats up and rises. This continues till the whole water in the vessel heats up. This is known as convection.
Is convection also a method of transfer of energy of heat like conduction?
Yes, you are right, Raja. Convection takes place in liquids and gases.
The air also heats up because of the sun's heat. So, does it also rise like water?
Shall we do an experiment? We will need these materials: a broad cylindrical glass tube, one candle, one incense stick, one round cardboard with two holes, tape, matchbox. Come, let us light the candle and place this broad glass tube over it. Now cover the glass tube with the cardboard and secure it with the tape. Remember to place the cardboard in such a way that one hole is right on top of the flame of the candle. Now, light the incense and place it over the other hole. Now, let us wait and watch what happens.
Look, the smoke from the incense stick is coming out from hole above the candle.
Yes, but how did the smoke from the incense go inside the glass tube?
think?
The hot air around the candle is coming out and the cold air from around the incense stick is going inside.
And then the air which went inside is becoming hot and rising from the other hole.
Good job, children.
This means that hot air rises and the cold air takes its place.
Mala, do you remember that in the science exhibition in school, a child had made a model in which he had explained something about the similar flow of air around the seaside?
Yes, I remember, but not clearly. Come, let us read in our science book. Look, it is written here that during the day, the land heats up faster than the water and the air above it rises. To occupy that space, cold air from the sea comes in and takes its place. This is known as sea breeze. During the night, the opposite happens. Water in the sea cools down slowly than land, and therefore cold air from the land blows towards the sea and warm air from the sea comes and takes its place. This is known as sea breeze.
This explanation is exactly like the experiment we just did. Like the cold air from near the incense went in and the hot air rose up from above the candle. Likewise, the currents around the seaside are examples of natural convection. The sun also gives us heat, but there is no medium between the sun and the earth. So then, how does the heat from the sun reach us?
Yes, a medium is required for transfer of heat in conduction and convection. So, how does transfer of heat take place without a medium from the sun? Come, let us look in the book. Look, it is written here that the heat from the sun reaches earth through radiation.
Radiation? Show me the book. It is also written here that there is no medium needed for radiation. That means transfer of heat takes place by three means: conduction, convection, and radiation.
Raja, wear something warm. It is getting cold now.
Mother, warm clothes gives us warmth. In summers, we wear light clothes with light colors.
Yes, you are right. We wear light-colored clothes in summers because light colors reflect the heat and hence we feel less warm. And in winters, we wear dark colors because dark colors absorb heat and hence we feel warm.
Oh, so let me wear my red sweater.
Now the water mother heated for you to take a bath has cooled down. Let us do our homework or else the teacher will scold us tomorrow.
So friends, you understood about convection and radiation. We also learned that the weather on the beach is always pleasant. Now when all of you want to choose clothes to wear, I'm sure you will think about the weather first. We shall meet soon.